यूनिट 6 डिजिटल सिग्नल प्रोसेसर पार्ट 3 सो फिक्स्ड एंड फ्लोटिंग पॉइंट रिप्रेजेंटेशन इन रियल लाइफ वी डील विथ अ रियल नंबर्स numbers with fractional part. So most modern computer have a native that is hardware support for floating point numbers. However, the use of the floating point is not necessary, the only way to represent a fractional numbers. This article describes the fixed point representation of the real number, and the use of the fixed point data type is used widely in digital signal processing and game application. Where performance is sometimes more important than precision. So the fixed point arithmetic is much faster than the floating point arithmetic. So the fixed point instruction detail, those are common for TMS 320C62X, 4X, 64X and 7X processor. The syntax of the instruction, the functional unit and addressing mode is given here. So first is the fixed point representation. Now, the shifting process above the shifting process is the key to understand fixed point number representation. To represent a real number in computer or any hardware in general, we can define a fixed point number type simply by implicitly fixing the binary point to be at some position of numeral. We will then simplify to this implicit convention when we represent numbers. To define a fixed point type conceptually, all we need are two parameters. One is width of the number representation and binary point position with number. So we will use this notation fix w comma b for the rest of the part, where w denote the number of bits used as a whole, the width of a number, and b denote the position of binary point counting from the least significant bit counting from zero. So here example is given where fixed 8,3. So 8 bit fixed point number, of which 3 rightmost bits are functional. So the bit pattern is given here. It represents the real number. So it is 2.75. Now on computer, a bit pattern can represent anything. That is, therefore, the same bit pattern, if we cast it to another type such as a fixed, will represent the number. So it is given here. So depending on where the binary point is assumed to be, a given number can be interpreted as a several different values to make programming simpler. We generally use a fixed binary point throughout the algorithm to easily specify how many bits are used to represent the integer and fractional part of the number. We use a notation called Q format. So for example, to specify that we are using 3 bits for the integer part and 4 bits for the fractional part, we may say that the numbers are in Q3.4 format. Another possible notation is to specify only the length of the fractional part. This is based on the assumption that the word length is known for a given processor. For example, when working with a processor which has a word length of 16 bit, we may simply say that we are using the Q15 format to represent the number. This means that we are putting this means that we are putting 15 bits to the right of the binary point and 1 bit to its left. In this case, the Q15 format is equivalent to the Q1.15 format. So here is the diagram for So here word length is given bit 0 to 15 the MSP bit and LSP bits. Then S represent sign bit, 0 represent position 1 negative F for fractional part. So we can calculate the coded number by using this equation. Next is floating point representation. Floating point representation. Here a binary floating point number x is represented as the product of two signal numbers, the mantissa m and the exponent e. So equation for this is given here. Now the floating point representation IEEE single precision format is given here. Bits 0 to 31, 0 to bit 22, these are significant field, and these are exponent field, and bit 22 it is implicit binary point. So MSB bits are bit 16 to 31 and 0 to 15 are least significant bit. So IEEE floating format is given here. One of the most widely used binary floating system is IEEE 754 standard. So the format for the single precision is shown here. Here floating point numbers with exponent in the range e is in the range 0 to 55 are said to be normalized. So the decimal equivalent x of normalized IEEE FE number is given by, where f is given by this equation. F is the mantissa into its complement binary fraction represented by bits 0 to 22, e is the exponent in excess 127, and s is 0 for positive number. So for the FP number, the format is given here. In fixed point, there are some instruction, like first one is move instruction. So the move instruction are used to move the contents between the register of the register file, control register file to register file, and also to move the 16 bit constant into the lower and upper bits of the register file. Then to move the contents between the registers of LSD units are used to move the values between the control register file and register file dot S2 unit alone is used. To move 16 bit constant to the register of the file, S1 S2 units are used, but in TMS 32664X processor, for the same 16 bit constant move operation, all LSD units are used. The register file cross path is not accessible for move instruction. So the addressing mode used for the move instruction is only register addressing mode. So first move instruction is the move. Here functional units are L1 or L2, S1 or S2, D1 or D2. So move the value from one register to
another register in register file. Second instruction is MVC. So functional unit is S2 only. Move value between the control register file and the register file. Then MVK, it is move 16-bit constant into upper 16-bit of the register. Then MVKLH, that is move 16-bit constant into upper 16-bits of register. MVKH is move upper 16-bit value of 32-bit constant to upper 16-bits of the register. Next is the load and store instruction. Now the load and store instruction are used for the memory to register file and register file memory data transfer through load and store data path respectively. The various types of the load and store instructions are based on byte, half word and word access. For load and store instruction, linear and circular addressing modes are used. The offset value given in the instruction is scaled by left side of 0, 1 or 2 for byte, half word or word access respectively. It is added or subtracted from the base register content based on the address modification specified in the instruction. The functional unit used for the load and store instruction with the register offset or 5-bit constant offset are D1 and D2 unit. So here instructions are, first is LDB or STP. It means that load byte from memory to the register in register file and store byte from register in register file to memory. Next is LDBU. It means load byte unsigned from memory to register in register file. Next is LDH or STH. It means load half word from memory to register in register file. Store half word from register in register file to memory. Next, LDHU means load half word unsigned from memory to register in register file. Next, LDW or STW means load word from memory to register in register file or stored word from register in register file to memory. So these are the load and store instructions. Next is add instruction. There are various types of add instruction of TMS320C6X processor. So all add instruction use register addressing mode except the addition using addressing mode instructions. Addition with addressing mode instruction are circular addressing mode. The signed integer addition with and without saturation, unsigned integer addition, 16-bit constant and 2 16-bit integer addition operation can be performed using add instruction. To perform the signed integer addition operation, all dot s, l and d function units are used, and for unsigned integer addition and integer addition with saturation, l1 l2 units are used. So here instructions are add. It means that the signed integer addition without saturation. Next, add u means unsigned integer addition without saturation. Then SADD means integer addition with saturation to result size. Also there are three more instructions, that is add k, it means integer addition using signed 16-bit constant. Add 2 means 2 16-bit integer additions on upper and lower register halves. Also add b or add ah or add aw, it means integer byte or half word or word addition using addressing mode. So these are the addition instructions.
Next is subtract instruction. So the various types of the subtract instruction of C6X processor and is given here. All the subtract instruction use the register addressing mode except subtracting using subtraction using addressing mode instruction. The subtraction with register addressing mode instruction uses circular addressing mode, signed integer subtraction with and without saturation, unsigned integer subtraction, conditional integer subtraction and 216-bit integer subtraction operations can be performed using subtract instruction. To perform a signed integer subtraction, all LSD function units are used. So the instructions are, first is the SUB, that is signed integer subtraction without saturation, for dot D units source 1 is subtracted from source 2. Next sub U, it means unsigned integer subtraction without saturation. Next is sub C, it means conditional integer subtract and shift used for division. Sub B, it means integer addition with subtraction to result size. There are two more instructions. Sub 2, it means 216-bit integer subtraction on upper and lower register values, register halves. And the last is sub AB or sub AH or sub AW, it means integer byte or half word or word subtraction using addressing mode. Next is the multiply instruction. All multiply instructions use the register addressing mode in this TMS320C6X type. The various instructions and of the multiply instructions are of signed and unsigned byte. The multiplication operation can be performed on 16 LSB or 16 MSB or 16 LSBs and with 16 MSBs and vice versa on register file register contents. The integer multiplication with left shift and saturation can also be performed on lower and higher order register contents of the register file. So these instructions are MPY or MPYEU. It means signed unsigned integer multiplication on 16 LSB. MPYH or MPYHU means signed integer signed unsigned integer multiplication on 16 MSB. Now, if in instruction it is L, then it is for LSB. If it is in H, then MSB. Then MPYLH, it means sign, or LHU, it means sign inside integer multiplication of 16 LSBs and 16 MSBs. Then MPYUS or YSU, it means unsigned and signed integer multiplication of 16 LSB. Then next is logical shift and compare instruction. So like other processes, this processor also supports a logical operation, arithmetic and logical shift operation, signed and unsigned integer compare operations. The arithmetic shift support both left and right shifting of the register content, but in logical shift instruction only right shift is possible. In both arithmetic and logical shift operation, when register is used, the 6 LSBs specify the shift amount. The shift value is 0 to 40, and for immediate value given in the instruction, the shift amount is 0 to 31, that is 5 bits. In the case of the shift left with saturation instruction, the shift amount 031 for both register and immediate time. If the shift amount is greater than the 31 bits, then the result is saturated to 7FFF4 times FH. So in all the cases, the shift value should be an unsigned number. So the first instruction is NOT, that is bitwise NOT sudo operation, AND bitwise AND sudo operation, or bitwise OR sudo operation, NEG, that is negate sudo operation, SHL, that is arithmetic shift left, SHR, arithmetic shift right, SHRU, logical shift right, SSHL, shift left with saturation. Then CMPEQ, that is integer compare for equality, CMPGT, signed unsigned integer compare for greater than, and CMPLT or LTU, it means signed in unsigned integer compare for less than. Next is branch and other instruction. So the location to which the branch could occur is specified as the label in the branch label, that is displacement in the branch instruction, or register in the register file, or interrupt return pointer, or NMI, that is non-maskable interrupt return pointer, can hold it. So the branch using displacement instruction is processed by dot S1 or S2 units. These instructions are used to set, clear, or extract the information about the field, about the bit field. The ABS norm and SAT instruction, these are used for handling signed bits of the operands. The NOP instruction is used in programming to avoid conflict between the functional unit in the pipeline operation. The idle instruction is used to halt the processor operation until interrupt occur. So here the instructions are, first is B, it means branch using displacement or using a register. BIRP or BNRP means branch using an interrupt return pointer or using NMI, that is non-maskable interrupt return pointer. CLR, clear bit field. Set a bit field. EXT, extract and sign extended bit field. EXTU, extract and zero extended bit field. LMBD, leftmost bit detection. Zero register. ABS is integer absolute value with saturation. Norm, normalize integer. SAT, saturate a 40-bit integer to a 32-bit integer. NOP, no operation. And idle means multi-cycle NOP with no termination until interrupt. Now next is conditional operations in the DSP processor. So most instructions can be conditional. The condition is controlled by 3-bit opcode field that specifies the condition registers tested and 1-bit field that specifies a test for zero or non-zero. The 4 MSBs of every opcode are C, R, E, G, and Z, and the specified condition register is tested at the beginning of E1 pipeline stage for all instructions. If Z is 1, then the test is for the equality with 0. If Z is 0, then the test is for non-zero. The case of CREG0Z0 is treated as always true to allow instructions to be executed unconditionally. The CREG field is encoded in the instruction. So here register that can be tested by conditional operations are, here specified conditional registers are given unconditional reserved B0, B1, B2, A1 and A2. So bits are also given here. The conditional instructions are represented in code by using a square bracket surrounding the condition register name. So the following it execute the packet contain two add instruction in parallel. The first add is a conditional on B0 being non-zero. The second add is conditional on B0 being 0. The character indicate the inverse condition. So these instructions are mutually exclusive, only one will execute. If they are scheduled in parallel, mutually exclusive instructions are constrained. If mutually exclusive instructions share any resource, they cannot be scheduled in parallel, even though only one will execute.